Through the years, we have been fortunate to have so many loyal donors supporting Delaware athletics. You've cheered and been proud of our student athletes as they compete, excel in the classroom, and represent us in the community. 2020 has presented so many of us with challenges, but through it all, we remain committed to what makes us great. Commitment, action, kindness, and family. While the fall season of competition isn't taking place, our student athletes aren't sitting idle. They are putting in the hard work to make sure they return to competition more prepared and stronger than ever. As the sports season is stalled, so too are many of the revenue streams we've relied on, presenting us with financial challenges as we continue to provide crucial resources and opportunities for more than 600 student athletes. As Fightin' Blue Hens, we don't cower in the face of adversity. We face it head on with grit and determination, just as our student athletes do in competition. In order to emerge stronger than ever, we need you to fight with us by having the backs of our student athletes, reminding them they still have a community of supporters cheering them on and advancing their success, no matter how hard the situation around us. Together, we can back the Blue Hens to ensure the blue and gold spirit not only remains, but thrives.
We are here at Rulo Stadium. We have two teams fighting to become your 2013 NCAA champion. Pete with a shot and a goal! In the first minute of the game, Esme Pete gets the blue. No, stop apartment. And a shot to Kastner. And then poked in by Casey Prettyman. And the Blue Hens have a 2-0 lead. A shot. And there's a goal! Shot. And a save by Sarah Scher. Takes it to the circle. Set West can take a shot. Good save there by Garner. Another shot. Michaela Pastner in front of the goal. Michaela Pastner puts it in. The University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens have defeated the Northeastern Huskies to capture their first NCAA championship title since 2009 and their third overall. They will head to the NCAA Tournament, their fourth time in school history.
Will face the winner of a play-in game between Liberty and Delaware.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hens All Access's coverage of NCAA Tournament field hockey. We are here at Rulo Stadium on the campus of University of Delaware where the Fightin' Blue Hens are taking on the Liberty Flames. I'm Kyle Coulter alongside Jess Calderon. Jess, how are we doing today?
Doing great, Kyle. A little chilly out here, but it's a beautiful day for some field hockey.
It is a little chilly, but there's partly cloudy, the sun's shining down. It's not deterring any of the fans. They're showing up here. We've got fans from both Liberty and Newark here showing up to cheer on their teams. And this should be a very interesting matchup. As you know, the Blue Hens won their third CAA tournament title. They beat Northeastern this weekend by a score of 5-1. To move to their also making their fourth NCAA tournament appearance, and the Liberty Flames coming out of nowhere. This is their third year that they've had a field hockey program. They swept the Northern Pacific Field Hockey Conference, and they just beat number 10 Stanford in the finals of that conference this weekend to move to the NCAA tournament. Both teams very even. What are you thinking about this game that we're about to see?
Kyle, there's a lot of young talent on both teams here, a lot of freshman talent highlighting all conference honors. For Liberty Flames, there's actually three sisters, a set of twins and another sister, who lead Liberty in many of the offensive categories.
Yes, you are referencing the three sisters from Ireland who are just tearing up this team as well as the conference. They rank first, second, and third in points in the conference. That's Natalie Barr, Serena Barr, and Bethany Barr. All three, two freshmen and one sophomore from Ireland coming over here and just carrying this team, really, along with also Ashley Krulock and Hannah Jones. But like I said, these teams very similar. A lot of foreign talent coupled with some senior leadership. Liberty, a very young team. They only have three seniors on the team, and most of the goal scoring has come from underclassmen this year, and that's very similar to the Blue Hens. Michaela Patzner, Esme Pete, Megan Winesett, all freshmen or sophomores contributing big numbers to this offense, as well as Casey Prettyman and Claire O'Malley and Sarah Scher, the seniors that really the anchor of this team, and it should be very interesting. I keep mentioning how similar these teams are, even down to the goalkeepers. They both post a 16-4 record, as well as six shutouts. Sarah Scher just winning the CAA Tournament Most Valuable Player. So great honor for the senior. She's playing in her last home game here today. No, regardless of the outcome, it will be the Blue Hens' last home game. They were stellar at home this year, only losing one match. They swept the CAA Tournament, which was played here at Rulo Stadium. And the winner of this game will move on down to North Carolina, where they'll take on UNC, the third-ranked team in the country. And the NCAA tournament, it's very East Coast-heavy this year. And in the top 12, there are seven teams from the ACC. And the Blue Hens are the only team representing the CAA. And, you know, it's the Blue Hens, they could be a bracket buster this year. They've got a lot of talent, and they're confident. They've won seven straight games, and that's only to be outdone by Liberty, who's on a 12-game winning streak currently, haven't lost since September. So it's going to be a fun one here at Rulo Stadium. And it's, as you mentioned, it's a little chilly, but I'm sure the girls are hyped right now. Liberty making their first NCAA tournament appearance, led by the NORPAC Coach of the Year. That would be Jody Murphy in her third season as head coach. She's won the NORPAC Coach of the Year two straight years in a row. And the Blue Hens have a pretty stellar coach as well, Rolf van de Kerkhoff, who won CAA Co-Coach of the Year. So some great leadership and a lot of young talent on both sides of the ball. It's going to be a lot of fun.
I think we're going to see a great game here, Kyle. Looking at some numbers, Liberty has scored 82 goals this season. Delaware has scored 68, as we talked about. Both goalkeepers have a 16-4 overall record with six shutouts. I think we're going to see a great overall game, offense, defense, and goalkeeping today here at Rulo Stadium.
And the Blue Hens defense really weren't tested too greatly in the CAA tournament. They beat the Tribe of William & Mary 4-2, and then they beat Northeastern 5-1. All three of those goals coming late in the game when the game was pretty much well in hand. And but they're definitely going to have to step up their game today against the Flames. Big matchup I'm going to look for is senior Heather Hartman, who's most likely going to be on Natalie Barr, the leading goal scorer for Liberty. 19 goals, 11 assists. We'll see how the freshman matches up with the senior. So a lot of talent against a lot of experience here. And the Blue Hens, they've been in this scenario before. Sarah Scher was on this team back in 2009. She didn't play, but she says she's really looking forward to the opportunity. And you know, we're ready to go here at Rulo Stadium. I'm sure the girls are all excited. I was able to talk to Michaela Patzner earlier today. Actually, I saw her walking around campus, and she said, you know, I feel confident. I feel good. We had a good couple days of practice, and they're really excited to be playing here at their home field for the last time of the season.
You know, Kyle, like we talked about last week, come postseason, everyone's record is wiped clean, and anyone can beat any other team on any given day. So whoever wins this game today, I think, has a great opportunity to go down to UNC, down to Chapel Hill, and get an upset over UNC.
Yes, and both teams had a lot of postseason honors. The Liberty has, I'm counting, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different postseason awards, including the NORPAC East Offensive Player of the Year, which was Natalie Barr, and the Rookie of the Year, which was her sister, Serena Barr, and then Bethany Barr also got in there as well with the Northern Pacific All-Tournament team, and the Blue Hens are right up there with them. They had five or six players who got recognized, as well as a conference-leading 9 players on the All-Tournament team. So it's such a heavyweight battle, and we're going to get into starting lineups here real quick for the Liberty University Flames. In goal, redshirt senior, Ann Jeffress. And then at midfield, Hannah Darity, a sophomore. And then Hannah Jones, a sophomore defenseman. Serena Barr, freshman defenseman / midfielder. Helen Doolittle, a junior defenseman. Bethany Barr, freshman midfielder. Sarah Geip, sophomore forward. Aaron Dombach, sophomore midfielder. Ashley Krulock, sophomore forward. Natalie Barr, the sophomore forward, Olivia Carroll, the freshman defenseman, and rounding out the starting lineup for the Flames, Michaela Sloman, the senior midfielder from Comga, South Africa. So a lot of different international talent here. And moving up to the number 14th ranked University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens, in goal, the senior Sarah Scher on defense, senior Heather Hartman, at midfield, the freshman Esme Pete, the CAA Player of the Year, as well as Rookie of the Year, the only player to do that since 1997. Senior midfielder Claire O'Malley plays more of a defensive role. Rebecca Pepper, the junior defenseman. Marielle Sheffers, freshman midfielder. Michaela Patzner, who leads the team in points and the CAA as well. She's a sophomore midfielder from Rosenheim, Germany. Megan Weinsett, freshman forward. Casey Prettyman, the senior forward, who had a stellar CAA tournament, so we're going to look to keep that up from her. 23, Janelle Holmes, a sophomore defenseman. 28, Allie Michelson, the sophomore midfielder. That will do it for your starting lineups. And we were here every step of the way for the Blue Hens run through the CAA tournament. And the top four goal scorers, Michaela Pastner, Esme Pete, Megan Weinsett, and Casey Prettyman, scored in both games. So they're coming in with some fire. And, the same for Liberty. In their 2-1 win over number 10 ranked Stanford, Natalie Barr had the two goals in their 2-1 win. So it's a lot of both teams coming in with a lot of momentum. Liberty beating their first ranked opponent in four tries, and they're going to have another shot at another ranked opponent today, as the Blue Hens are ranked 14th, as I mentioned. And the NORPAC, not a powerhouse of a field hockey conference, but they did take on Stanford, who I mentioned is top 10 in the nation, and they grinded that win out 2-1, so they know how to win in tight games. And I have a feeling that's what this one's going to be here.
It's going to be a great game, Kyle. Like we said earlier, comparing numbers, 82 goals to 68 goals. Liberty's leading scorer has 19 goals, 11 assists. Delaware's Michaela Patzner has 20 goals, 16 assists. It's going to be a great overall game today here, Kyle. We talked about last week with the CAA. Whatever team scores first here today is going to have that momentum, and that's what we're going to look forward to see. We're going to see who can get that first goal in the back of the cage.
And against Northeastern, you weren't here for this game, the CAA championship. The Blue Hens scored within the first 30 seconds of the game. Esme Pete nailed a corner to put the Blue Hens up 1-0. And just some interesting stats here on the Liberty Flames. Over their last 12-game winning streak, they have outscored their opponents 57-9 with five shutouts. So not only is their offense clicking on all cylinders, but their defense as well. The Blue Hens are doing just as well, if not better. Over their CAA tournament run, they outscored their opponents 9-3. And in the Northern Pacific Conference games, Liberty outscored their opponents 9-2. So once again, very even. Liberty with a 17-4 overall record swept their conference. Blue Hens with a 16-4 overall record swept their conference. And they're both playing each other for the first time in either program's history. And we're about to get underway as Sarah Scher gets her team pumped up. The CAA tournament MVP.
I think Cher's going to have her hands full today, Kyle. Not that she's not expecting it, but I think we're going to see a lot of action out of the Blue Hen goalkeeper today from this Liberty Flames team that has a high-powered offense.
It looks like the Blue Hens will get the ball to start. Front line of Megan Weinsett, Esme Pete, and Michaela Patzner. Some freshmen and some underclassmen power there. All right, and we are underway here at Rulo Stadium. Prettyman plays it out wide to Hartman. Back up to Prettyman. Patzner with it now. Call against the Flames. Cut out nicely there. Picked up by Natalie Barr.
It's going to be an obstruction call there against the Blue Hens. Liberty will have a free hit.
And the ball now goes back to the Blue Hens. Hartman will take it. Cut out there nicely by the Flames. Taken up wide by Marielle Sheffers. And a collision there.
There's no call from the... Is there a call there? There's...
Seems like we will get a call there from officials. Seemed like it was kind of an inadvertent collision, but the ball will go back to the Blue Hens. Play back to Hartman. Hartman looking for Pete. Cut out there by Bethany Barr, the freshman from Lurgan, Northern Ireland. As I mentioned, one of three Barr sisters on this team. Good takeaway there off the stick of Megan Winesett. CAA all-rookie selection as well as second team, all-CAA. She had a stellar tournament as well. Sheffer's battling for it with Barr. There's number 14, Sarah Geip, the captain. Ball's played up forward to Pastner. Pastner battling with Barr, and he got a call there against the Flames. Playing in the middle for Prettyman. Prettyman looking to just blast it past the broken line. That ball's out there to Ashley Krulock. And that ball go off the stick of the Blue Hens, back to the Flames.
Delaware really pressing here, Kyle. They're trying to get the ball in that circle and get the first corner opportunity of the day.
Which, as we mentioned, they capitalized on against Northeastern, scoring two quick goals in the opening minutes.
Ball's played out wide to Helen Doolittle, junior defenseman from Lancaster, Pennsylvania.
Lofted up.
Lofted a little too high there, Kyle. That ball will be just outside the broken line for a free hit from the Blue Hens.
O'Malley looking to play it across. Cut out there by the Liberty defense. And good hustle there from Barr, but unable to save it. O'Malley. Good defense there
from number 28, Michaela Sloman, another captain on this team, a senior, one of the only three seniors on this squad. Call there against Bethany Barr.
Played back to Holmes, who also had a very nice tournament as well.
That was a great job there by Mickelson, finding her sweeper to try to change fields, but the pass up to the midfield just goes out of bounds.
Yep, Allie Michelson, the sophomore midfielder from McCungee, Pennsylvania.
The back line for the Blue Hens been playing very well this season, only giving up 1.4 goals per game. Patzner with it in the corner. Good defense there from the Flames. Be a long hit there from the corner. So the Flames have yet to have the ball controlled down on their side of the field yet. Blue Hens doing a nice job keeping possession and pressing. Ball goes out to O'Malley, but that one will roll out of play. This AstroTurf surface here so fast. As we've seen, you really have to have pinpoint accurate passes, especially with the wind blowing down today down at the surface. Good defense there from Pastner. We're going to get a call there against the sophomore.
That was great pressure there from Pastner, the forward coming up and really putting pressure on the Liberty Flames sweeper there. She tried to switch fields if Pastner was there, even though it will give a free hit opportunity to the Flames. It was great pressure by Pastner.
Flames just trying to get it over their midfield line. And they do. Still with it now. There's Barr. I'm going to get a call against the Flames.
This is a much different start than we saw in the semifinal match for the Blue Hens between the Blue Hens and Drexel. Both the game was evenly played throughout the first probably 15 minutes being played in the middle of the field. But here, the Blue Hens have maintained possession pretty much the entire first start of this game.
Over 5 minutes to play. Neither team has recorded a shot on goal yet, but the Blue Hens have held possession for most of it, but the ball goes back now to the Flames. They are just outside, now just inside the 25. Looking in for Barr. One of the three Barrs.
That's great pressure there by Casey Prettyman for the Blue Hens. Ball is at the 25. She pushed it all the way back out to almost midfield.
That's Serena Barr. Up into the middle. We're going to get a shot. Saved by Cher. So a good swing out there by Barr. Good save by Cher. She records her first of the day. And the ball goes to the Blue Hens. Marielle Sheffers plays it back to Holmes. And the Flames putting on just as much pressure down their end. Hartman trying to clear it.
Yeah, that proves right there, Kyle. It doesn't matter who has possession for most of the game. It's just whoever can take advantage of their possessions first. And today, Liberty had registered the first shot on goal.
And it was a good one, too. But Cher, as I mentioned, the CAA tournament's most valuable player, saved that one. Balls out wide to O'Malley. Put it up to Winesett. Back to O'Malley now. Barr on defense. Michelson cut out there.
That was a great thought there by Michelson, trying to change fields over to the right side, but the Liberty Flames midfielder stepped up and made a good poke on the ball, and now the ball will be in the possession of the Flames.
And apologies if we don't get the names for the Flames. The numbers are quite small on the far side of the field. But hopefully when they switch sides in the halfway, we'll get that other side some recognition it deserves because they're playing very well over there. It'll be a free hit for the Flames.
Ball's played up to Olivia Carroll. Carroll into the middle.
Flames have another shot here. They're inside the circle. That ball a little bit behind Barr. Passner cuts it out.
That was a great look to the top of the circle there from the Flames, but the pass was just a little behind Barr, which allowed the Blue Hens to step up and take away the pass and now move downfield. The ball goes out of bounds, and it'll be back in the hands of the Flames.
And that's Hannah Jones, sophomore defenseman from Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania, on that left side.
Cuts that away from Passner. Ooh, that ball taken off the leg. Cold, it's got to hurt, but they're tough. Winesett up the right side. Be a call there against the Flames. Passner wastes no time. Looks like it's going to be a call against, still against the Flames, but Pete was a little too gung-ho starting that one off.
That was a great job by Winesett, really seeing she didn't have any number opportunities there, so she just simply put the ball right into the feet of the Flames defense to get a free hit.
Here's Barr moving up, cut out nicely by Holmes. That's Bethany Barr. Barr still with it now.
Played back to Doolittle.
Out wide. Good hustle there. Number 22, Olivia Carroll. The ball goes back to the Blue Hens. Back to Sheffers. Cut out there by four Flames surrounding Sheffers, making sure she couldn't get it. She couldn't clear the ball for the Blue Hens. Barr trying to sneak it through to her sister. Good defense there from Janelle Holmes.
Great job by Holmes. As a defender, you're taught when the ball's in the circle to keep your stick on the ground at all times, and that's exactly what Holmes did and was able to get the call against the Flames for a Blue Hen free hit.
Good stick work there from Sheffers. Cut out there by Barr. Going to get a call against the Flames. Ball goes back to the Blue Hens. So two very, very similar styles of play here coming from both. They're putting a lot of pressure on the defense, making it hard for each team to clear. Hartman stumbles, but she's able to get back up, but the ball goes out of bounds.
Looking at this Liberty team, Kyle, if you had not mentioned this is only the third year of the program, I would have no idea. On the field, they look just as much of a veteran team as the Blue Hens do here today so far in this game.
Yeah, very interesting. They only started their program 3 years ago, joining the NORPAC Conference. And they've had significant success the past 2 years, getting better each year. They made their conference tournament last year, lost, then they made it again this year and swept every team, and now they're here in the NCAA tournament, taking on the Blue Hens, who have also had a very successful year. Sheffers. Holmes will take the free hit for the Blue Hens.
And Jordan Richardson is in for the Flames. And Maddie O'Byrne will also check in for the Blue Hens. Scored a goal against William and Mary.
Excuse me. That was in the CAA championship game against Northeastern. Another young talented player here on the Blue Hens squad.
The Flames are doing a great job here today on all Blue Hen free hits. They are finding their marks. They're marking it very well, and it's creating a lot of difficulty here for Delaware getting the ball moving forward and to not be able to get off free passes. That's something Delaware has done so well this year is free passes, moving the ball from their defenders up to their midfielders, up to their forwards. And I'm guessing Liberty watched the game film, and their coaches, you know, advised them you need to mark up on your players and keep them from getting the ball forward.
I'm sure both teams very well prepared for this game. Both coaches winning coach of the year in their respective conferences. That ball played in the middle. Cut out there by Sheffers. Right place at the right time for Marielle Sheffers. Ball almost got through to Jordan Richardson.
That was a great pass into the circle. I can't see by the number. It looks like it is number 19 from the Flames, Natalie Barr. That was a great quick pass. And on this turf, when you get that quick pass off like that, that's when things happen in the circle.
Now at the right side is Olivia Carroll. Carroll taken in the middle. Cut out there by Pete. But there's a call against the freshman. The ball will go back. Still with the Flames now.
Liberty really trying to press and get the ball in the circle here and get their first corner opportunity of the game.
There's Doolittle trying to play it into the corner, and it goes off of the Blue Hens, so it'll be a long hit for the Flames. Number 15, Aaron Dombach out to take it, the sophomore midfielder from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Into Barr. Barr tiptoeing the sideline, played it in the middle. Hartman tried to clear it out, then O'Malley finally does. Ball's over to Prettyman, it looks like. Prettyman still with it now. Stick got caught up with Doolittle. Be a call against the Flames. Ball goes back to the Blue Hens as we are 13 minutes into this first half. Still scoreless here at Rouleau Stadium. Thank you for taking time out of your Wednesday afternoon to spend with us here at Hens All Access. Alongside Jess Calderon, I'm Kyle Coulter, proudly bringing you your Delaware field hockey. Ball's played in the middle. Blue Hens back on attack here. Prettyman, the senior, up to O'Malley. Another senior. He's going to take a shot. He's just trying to play into the middle. Cut out there nicely by the Liberty defense. And that ball a little too wide there for Jordan Richardson as Mercedes Cox checks in for the Flames. Junior forward from Manassas, Virginia. Holmes. Holmes still running with it now. Barr on defense. Barr and Pete going at it.
Well, head coach Ralph Van Kerkhoff did not agree with that call there. He wanted that call to go for the Hens, but the officials thought otherwise and gave the Flames a free hit.
And some physical play here in the first half. Both teams really coming out, want to get that first goal, that crucial first goal. Which with two stellar defenses could be the difference in this game. Heather Hartman up looking for O'Byrne. And it'll be a call against the Flames. Hartman to take it. The two Barr sisters, two of the three on defense there. Ball's played forward. She's got Prettyman. Prettyman's on a run. Jeffress comes out and kicks it away.
That was a great job there by Jeffress. She saw that Prettyman was the only Blue Hen in the circle. There was no one coming down the left side from a pass for Prettyman, so she charged out and got a nice clear. That's a great job there by Jeffress.
The Flames still running it with it. We're going to get a call against the Flames. Ball goes back to the Blue Hens.
Also good defense by Olivia Carroll there on that last run.
She had a one-on-one with Prettyman. Hartman tried to launch into the middle. Cut out there by Barr. Pepper playing with it along the sidelines. That ball goes off the stick of the Flames. Be Delaware's ball from the right corner. Played into Pete. Pete trying to get it around Barr. Good defense there from the Flames. They get the call. The ball will go back to Liberty.
That's an obstruction call there against the Blue Hens. When you're moving forward, your feet and body need to be moving forward with the ball. If you turn your back towards the defense, then you will get caught on for obstruction, and that's exactly what happened there for Delaware.
Play in the middle for Pete. Pete taking past the broken line. She was looking for O'Byrne, and that ball just goes over the stick of the sophomore. Good opportunity there. Good look from Pete. But the ball goes back to the Flames.
So far here, I think Delaware needs to do a better job with seeing the ball under their stick and maintaining passes and controlling passes. It seems a lot of balls are getting away from them here. That's something they definitely need to improve on for the rest of the match.
And that ball's up to Richardson. Richardson loses it to Janelle Holmes. Holmes, a dangerous pass, but finds Claire O'Malley all the way across the field as Jackie Kovaleski checks in for the Hens.
As well as Michaela Patzner.
So it's interesting, we saw in the CAA tournament, Rolf Vandekerkhoff didn't use a lot of subs, really stuck with a starting lineup. He had a plan, but I guess the plan has changed a little bit now. A little colder, trying to get some fresh legs warmed up in there. As Patzner comes back in along with Kovaleski. Ball's played out wide. That ball a little too far for Barr. Hartman has it now. Cut out there by the Flames. Barr and Hartman fighting for it. The matchup that I said we were going to look out for. Sophomore Natalie Barr, leading goal scorer on this team against senior defenseman Heather Hartman. They're matched up on the same side.
Barr's doing a great job on Blue Hen free hits that are taking place on the defensive side of the field. Barr's done a great job stepping up and taking away the stopper option for her to switch fields, and that's, I think, part of the success the Flames have had so far in this game.
Ball's put up to Mercedes Cox. Running along the sideline there. Looking in the middle, she's got Barr. Barr with a shot, and it goes just wide. So Natalie Barr had a good look at it. Cher came down to cut down the angle and forced an errant shot there from Natalie Barr. So a close one there for the Flames.
I think that was a little too close there. I don't think the Blue Hens like that much, but that was great passing there by the Flames, and a backhanded shot on net for Barr just goes wide left of the cage.
The Flames get the ball back. A one-timer there from Cox goes wide. Looked like she picked her head up before she really took a swing at that one.
You know, on this turf, you have to watch the ball all the way into your stick, Kyle. And she took her head off just a little bit. She saw a wide open shot on the net, I think, got a little excited and tried to swing just before the ball got to her. But the Flames are pressing, and I'm expecting more shots on net from Mercedes Cox.
And the press does its job. Barr once again gets the ball back for the Flames. Taking it up the right side on the end line. Pass into the middle. Cut out there by Sheffers, and it'll be a long hit for the Flames.
I'm really impressed, Kyle, by this Flames ball movement. They've had great passes right to stick, right off of stick to the next stick. They've been doing a great job here so far in this game.
And there's one of the younger Barrs, Bethany. Ball's played into the middle, and Janelle Holmes just has to clear it away.
I thought that was going to be a corner opportunity there for Liberty, Kyle. It seemed that the Delaware defense did not have their feet moving, kind of almost tackled the forward for Liberty, but the officials do not agree with me, and it will be a long hit for the Flames.
Michaela Sloman out to take it.
Sloman looking in the middle for Bethany Barr. Out there to pass, and we're going to get a call against the Hens. So the Flames really pressing here in the last 5 minutes. They've pretty much controlled possession. Sloman. That ball a little too far off the senior stick. Back to O'Malley. O'Malley looking to push now. Up the right side for Prettyman. A nice little pass there. And that's cut out by Serena Barr. What's that commercial? More bars in more places? I feel like that's what it is right now. I just keep saying the last name.
That was a great job there by Serena Barr. Really great hand-eye coordination there. The ball was lifted under her stick. She had a backhanded stop and then simply backhanded pass up to her forwards, and there the Flames go up the field again.
There's Natalie Barr, plays into the middle. Cut out there by Janelle Holmes. Holmes seems to be in the right place at the right time tonight. This afternoon, excuse me. As she was this whole weekend.
I think Liberty needs to focus more on getting the ball into the Blue Hens defenders' feet here when they get the ball in the circle. They've been making great passes, but the Delaware defense is phenomenal, to say the least, and they're not going to get that many quick passes like that the rest of the game. So to get a corner opportunity here, I think they really need to focus on getting the ball into the defenders' feet for the corners.
And Blue Hens finally able to clear it, but that ball a little too far for Jackie Kovaleski to get to.
And Ashley Krulak checks back in for the Flames, as well as Abby Basem, sophomore forward from Lancaster, Pennsylvania.
A lot of players from Pennsylvania here on this Flames squad. That's out of Virginia. And there's Prettyman. Prettyman's got some room. On defense is number 22, Olivia Carroll. Prettyman trying to play up the sideline.
That's a great job there by Kyle Prettyman. As you see, she was the first Blue Hen forward up the field, took the ball into the left corner, waiting for her other forwards and midfielders to join her. But it doesn't seem like that opportunity is going to work out for the Hens here as Liberty regains possession.
And it goes right back to the Blue Hens. Michelson trying to launch it into the middle, and that ball goes wide, looking for a deflection off a stick. And you see Michelson coming up there shaking her hand. It's got to... every little nick, every little pinch, every little bump, it's got to hurt a lot more as it is in the 30s here down on the field with some wind. And you were mentioning last broadcast how everything, when you're playing field hockey, it's a little tougher when it's cold.
Yeah, most definitely. Your hands are cold on that stick. A lot of players do have gloves on, but you get a nice hard hit off your stick, and just like swinging a baseball bat, it rattles all the way up your hands into your elbows.
Ball's played up to Pepper.
On defense is Serena Barr.
Looks to me a little bit the Blue Hens are kind of getting impatient here, Kyle. They haven't had to work that hard, as we said, CAA tournament. They pretty much dominated. We didn't have too many close games, but it seems they're getting frustrated trying to force passes. The Blue Hens really need to be patient and play their game. They can't change their game plan just because they're being a little more tested than they have been in their recent games.
But they are very used to big tests. They took on a few ranked opponents this year. Beat Temple, and they had a close match against the defending national champion Princeton here at Rulo. It's the only game they lost this year. That was 2-1. So they're no stranger to tough games, and their big players show up when they need to. And right now it's been pretty even so far. The Blue Hens, for the first 5 minutes, really held the ball down their end, and then for the next 10 minutes or so, it was the Flames' turn. It's really been going back and forth here. As we expected, as we've noted in pregame, these two teams very similar, a lot of young talent, and they both coming in with incredible amounts of momentum. The Flames with a nation-leading 12-game winning streak. And the Blue Hens right behind them with a 7-game winning streak.
This is most definitely the best all-around game I've seen. I was here for the Delaware semifinal matchup against Drexel, and I was here for Northeastern matchup against... Oh, I'm sorry, the Delaware matchup against...
William and Mary,
the Drexel matchup against Northeastern, and this is definitely the most evenly played contest we've had here at Delaware in the past week.
And just as I suspected, the stands are filling up here. Cold, not getting the best of these field hockey fans as they're coming out to cheer on their Blue Hens in their last home game of the season. And if you've been in Newark, you've been fortunate to come down here and watch these games at Rulo Stadium. I think they're now 11-1 at home this year, including the CAA tournament. So if you come to Rulo, most likely you're going to see a win. But the Blue Hens have their hands full right now with the Liberty Flames. We're approaching 10 minutes left to go here in the first half. The score is tied 0-0. As Barr takes in the middle, looking across, cut up by Sheffers. And Sheffers just has to play it out of bounds. Up to Carroll.
Looking down at the stands below us, Kyle, there's a lot of navy and red. Virginia not too far here from Newark. Delaware probably a straight shot up 95 from Lynchburg to Newark. And I will say the Flames have traveled well here today.
As Tony Papinko checks in for the Blue Hens, the senior, up to Kovaleski. Kovaleski back to O'Malley. In the middle for Michelson. Michelson has to retreat back. That ball a little far for Janelle Holmes. See if they can get to it before it goes out of bounds. Holmes is hustling for it, and she does get there in time at a dangerous pass from Kovaleski. Back the Blue Hens all the way up into their defending 25. There's a call there against the Flames, fortuitous for the Blue Hens. Hartman plays it ahead. Looking for Patzner. Name I haven't called much today. CAA leader in points as well as the team leader in points. Seems like the Liberty Flames have done a nice job marking up against her as well as Esme Pete tonight, this afternoon. Ball played in the middle. You're going to get a call there against the Blue Hens. Still no corner yet in this match for either side. Played out wide to Carroll.
It's a great reach by there by Carroll to keep the ball from going out of bounds. Passes a little too hard as a roll all the way to the fence and allow a Delaware free hit.
She was looking for Abby Basin.
Ball a little too far. Played back to Holmes. And that ball sneaks through Holmes. But Cher is there, so dangerous turnover there from the Hens.
See what the Delaware defense here will do here with the Flames attacking hard into the circle.
And that ball out wide to Sloman. She'll take it right from the broken line, but the ref's telling her to back up a little bit. Sloman, guarded by Michelson and O'Malley, trying to tiptoe that sideline. Good defense there from O'Malley. The ball will go back to the Hens as we are 8 minutes away from halftime here at Rulo Stadium. Still scoreless. Once again, thank you for joining us here on Hens All Access for NCAA Tournament field hockey coverage. Alongside Jess Calderon, I'm Kyle Coulter. Ball play up the sideline by Sheffers. Sheffers, nice job there to get it around the two Flames defensemen. Papinko looking forward to Pete. Here's a good string of passing here from the Hens. Inside to Patzner. Carroll on defense. Patzner looking out wide to Prettyman. Prettyman takes it over the broken line. And cut out there nicely by Bethany Barr. Prettyman still has it, though. Cut out again by Barr. He's going to get a call from the broken line. Patzner will take a free hit. And Natalie Barr and Sarah Geip check back into the game. That ball off the stick of the Flames will be a long hit for the Hens. Looks like that's Pepper out to take it. MO for Papinko. Trying to get it into that circle. Get a call against the Flames.
She did get into the Flames forward's feet there, but it was just outside of the circle. Just a couple more inches and she would have had a corner chance there.
Ball's into the middle and the Blue Hens now have won a corner. The Flames didn't seem to like that call. Thought it might have gone off the Hens out of bounds. But the Blue Hens do get the call, and they will have the first corner opportunity for either team here with just under 6.5 to play here in the first half. Blue Hens scored 3 of their goals in the CAA Championship game off corners. Let's see if they can do it again. Michelson will be the inserter, as always. We'll see who takes the shot. It could be Pastner, it could be Pete. That's one of the beauties of this Delaware offense. You never know who's going to take the shot. They have a lot of different plays set up. Prettyman scored off a corner last game. There's the stop. It's going to be Pastner with a shot. Save. Fleury in front of the goal. Pete's going to take a shot at it. Played in the middle for Pastner. Going to get a call there against the Hens. So good defense there from the Flames. We saw their keeper, Ann Jeffress, play it much like Sarah Sher always plays a corner, just getting down immediately to stop any low shot. And it worked for her on that one. So Blue Hens get the first corner opportunity of the game.
That was a great job there by Jeffress. She hadn't seen a shot all game, and she's throwing a couple shots right there, right in the circle. As you said, she spread out, took up as much space as possible, and the Hens weren't able to lift it over her and ended up fouling in the circle, allowing for a Flames free hit coming out.
So that's something, a stat you don't see often for this Blue Hens. It took them almost 30 minutes to record their first shot on goal. Only 3 combined for both teams. Flames with 2. Barr now into the middle. Hartman on defense. Barr's going to take a shot. Goes just wide right. Barr with a nice backhand strike there.
She got all of that too, Kyle. That was a hard shot right at Cher, but the ball goes just wide, and Delaware will regain possession for a free hit here.
Barr looking to notch her team-leading 20th goal of the season, which would double the next leading scorer, which is Ashley Krulak.
After seeing that shot, Kyle, seeing 19 goals from Barr, that does not surprise me. I don't care how much padding you have on as a goalkeeper. Seeing a shot come at you that hard is definitely intimidating.
I'm sure Sarah Sher is ready. She's a senior goalkeeper playing her last home game. She wants to make sure that this is not the last field hockey game she plays for the Blue Hens. As I mentioned, CAA tournament, most valuable player. She's played every minute in goal for the Blue Hens the past 2 seasons. Up to Papinko. Papinko up to Pete. With Doolittle on defense, that ball goes out just a little ahead of Pete's stick. Doolittle now with it.
Pete tried to get a backhanded stop on that. trying to take the easy way, didn't get her feet around the ball, but you know it goes back to the Blue Hens anyway.
Pastor trying to take a run. Ball goes call against the Flames. O'Malley will have it now as we have 3 minutes and 45 seconds left to go here in the first half. Pete trying to launch into the middle. And
that was not touched there, Kyle. It looked like there was almost a tip. I couldn't see. There was a herd of Blue Hens in front of the Liberty goalie, but the ball rolls into the back of the cage, and since no one touched it inside the circle, it will not count as a score.
That ball goes out wide, back to the Blue Hens.
I think what's going to be really important here in the second half as we wind down with the last 3 minutes of the first half, the Blue Hens really need to get a game plan. I think they need to take their free hits, free opportunities a little sooner, because when they're taking their time, Liberty's doing a great job of doubling on the ball and also stepping up and marking up. They're doing a great job defensively here.
O'Malley taking it up the left side.
As you see right there, they're doubling almost every time they can. They're stepping up and doubling the ball and seeing the offensive numbers of Delaware. That's not a bad idea there by Liberty's head coach.
Holmes, common collective, gathers that one with Barr charging. Plays it out to Sheffer. Sheffer's reversing field over to Hartman. Just trying to go around the Flames press.
That was a great job there by Hartman. That ball almost went 25 yards up to her midfield. There was a foul there by Liberty, and there'll be a Delaware free hit by Casey Prettyman.
And Rebecca Pepper will check back in for Claire O'Malley.
Ball played up to Pinko. Pinko still with it. We're going to get a call against the Flames. And the ref telling Pinko to back it up. She was trying to take it a little too quickly there.
Just a little bit. She stepped up about almost 10 feet in front of the spot of the foul. But sometimes, you know, you can get away with that. But not here today in this NCAA play-in game.
It's always worth a try. The winner of this game will go down this Saturday to Chapel Hill to take on the third-ranked team in the country, UNC. And Michelson and Richardson get tied up there. Ball played up to Patzner.
Minute 30 here left in the first half in Newark, Delaware. Flames leading with 3 shots on goal. Blue Hens have 1.
Patzner up across the broken line. Looking for Pinko. Pass over. And that goes just wide off the stick of, it looked like, Megan Winesett. And the Hens with a golden opportunity there. They had a 2-on-none against the goalkeeper, and they couldn't cash it in. I thought that was going to be a goal for sure.
I saw it fly up. I thought it was going into the back of the cage, but it went just right. That was definitely the best scoring opportunity by either team here today. It seemed like the touch off of the stick of the Blue Hens just went just a little bit high into the right.
I was getting ready for the goal call, and it just the ball. I saw the ball sail wide. So the Blue Hens had a golden opportunity there in the last minute of this first half. Come up with nothing, scores tilt tied 0-0. 30 seconds left. Flames trying to mount one last attack. This ball goes back to Sloman.
Flames really need to get the ball in the circle here if they want one more scoring opportunity of the first half.
The Blue Hens just looking to clear it. Holmes.
There you
and
go.
The Flames have won their first corner of the half. It will come as time expires. So the Blue Hens defense really needs to step it up here, as they've done this whole first half. And the Blue Hens, very good job this year defending against corners. But the Liberty offense, one of the most potent in the country. So we'll see. It looks like the inserter will be number 8, Hannah Jones.
That was a great job there by Liberty. Kyle, they had the ball in their own 25, brought it all the way up, got it into the circle quickly for their first corner opportunity of the game. The Blue Hen rush here is going to be absolutely crucial.
And here we go. Looks like Bethany Barr will be the stopper. Her older sister, Natalie Barr, looks like she'll be the shooter here. She's going to pass in the middle. Blue Hens need to clear it out of the circle. There's a shot. And there's a call against the Flames. That will do it for the first half. So the Blue Hens defense steps up when they need to, and we will go into halftime here at Rulo Stadium with a tie score of 0-0. Jess, what are your thoughts? What were your thoughts on the first half there? Very even matchup between both teams.
Very evenly played matchup. Like I said, Kyle, Liberty has really done a great job defensively. They're doubling almost every ball Delaware has. They're bringing up two defenders, two midfielders, forward and a midfielder. Delaware needs to find some way to get off quicker passes and get the ball into the circle to get some more corner opportunities.
And we will look to see what adjustments each team makes at halftime. Both teams playing very similar games so far, putting a lot of pressure on the offense to clear, generating a lot of turnovers, and only five combined shots between the two teams. Each goalie has one save. We're going to take it to a break, but don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with the second half here on Hens All Access.
Ew. Ew. Okay. Oh. Oh, no. Oh, God. No. Okay.
Both teams retake the field, and Jess Calderon is with me here. We're going to go over some second half stats. Shots, Liberty has five, Delaware two. The only four of those shots for Liberty coming from Natalie Barr, two of which were on goal. Blue Hens, two shots, Michaela Passner, Megan Winesett, only one of those was on goal. Both goalies playing well, two saves for Sarah Scher, one for Ann Jefferis. And we said it in the pregame, it is going to be a very even matchup between these two teams. Liberty coming in with a 12-game win streak. Blue Hens coming in with a 7-game win streak. Both swept their conferences. Both won their conference tournaments. Liberty coming off a huge win over number 10 Stanford, their first time beating a ranked opponent. And this game has lived up to expectations, to say the least.
Most definitely, Kyle. It's been a hard-fought first half here. Excuse me. I think whatever team is going to make the appropriate and correct halftime adjustments is going to come out and get this first goal in the second half.
And both teams have coaches that are capable of making the necessary adjustments. Rolf van de Kerkhoff and Jody Murphy, both winning Coach of the Year for their respective conferences. So a lot of leadership here, as well as a lot of young talent on both squads. As Liberty attacking early here, there's Barr. Played into the middle, cut out by Michelson. Looking up for Winesett. Winesett hits it out of bounds. Ball will go back to the Flames for number 15, Aaron Dombach.
Just how the first half ended, Kyle. The second half has started. Liberty pressing hard to get the ball into the circle here.
And they do. O'Malley trying to clear it away. Barr's got it now. Pete with it. Barr once again inside the circle. Maybe trying to get some kind of corner opportunity. Takes a shot. Saved there by Scher. We're going to get a call against the Flames. Hartman trying to clear it and be brought back by the ref.
I think that shot off the stick of Barr was just a little too high, a little too dangerous into the Delaware defense, and that was the call there against the Flames, and now Delaware will have opportunity to move the ball up in the field into their offensive zone.
Off the foot of Dombach. Pepper with it now. Pepper cut out there by Barr, one of the two freshman Barrs on the team. Esme Pete battling with Dombach. Haven't called Pete's name much today, the freshman, CAA player and rookie of the year. First player to win both honors since 1997. Second on the team in points behind Michaela Patzner.
I think that's just a testament to what a great job Liberty has done today on Delaware's top scorers here. They, like I said earlier, they've done a great job doubling the ball whenever it's been on the stick of a Blue Hen, and they've done a great job as well of marking up accordingly.
Yeah, only two shots for the Blue Hens so far in this game. It took them 30 minutes to get their first one. That came off a corner. So Liberty defense really playing well, and much credit to the Blue Hens defense as well. They've stepped up. They stopped a corner right before halftime and went into the halftime with some defensive momentum, which is always good. You want to make sure your defense is playing strong. And they have been all season. And this game, it's pretty much exactly how we thought it would play out. I thought maybe we'd see a little more offense, but I knew it would be even. Both teams very very balanced, a lot of young talent, as I mentioned, a lot of foreign talent. The three Barr sisters for Liberty, who are the top three of the top four on the team in points, all from Ireland. And the Blue Hens with Marielle Sheffers, Esme Pete, Mikhail Patzner, all from Europe. I remember doing an interview with Patzner and Pete and Sheffers, and they mentioned how complementary both styles of play are. The European style of play, a lot more finesse, very focused on stick work, and it blends well with the American hard-nosed, fast-paced style. And we've seen success that we've seen that both styles mesh and have success for both teams now, as they're playing an NCAA tournament play-in game.
I mean, that's what's great about sport and athletics in general, Kyle. You come into United States from a different country, everything's different. There's a little bit of culture shock, language barriers, but when you come out to do what you came here to do, and that's play field hockey, play soccer, play basketball, whatever it is, the sport doesn't change. The style may change a little bit, but the sport itself is still the same, and I think that's why international students have so much success coming to the United States to play.
And it seems like the one common translation across all countries is sports. And, you know, we've seen a lot of nationalities blend together and make a successful team. That is true for both Liberty and University of Delaware. And Pastner taken into the circle now, cut out there nicely by Carroll.
That was a great job there by Carroll, Kyle. She kept her stick on the ground, stepped up with the attack on the Delaware forward, and was able to keep her stick on the ball, and get a clear up to, I think that is Barr now moving forward quickly.
Barr being very beautiful control there with one hand on the stick. Pepper trying to poke it away from her. But Natalie Barr, the sophomore, 19 goals on the season, and you can see why. She's shown a lot of talent. She's got four shots already on the game. Now over 100 shots on the year.
I mean, Barr's done a great job today in field hockey, as everyone knows who's watching. You can only use one side.
Shot, a beautiful save there by Sarah Scher. Good opportunity there for the Flames. I believe that was Aaron Dombach in the middle there taking the shot. And it'll go out wide, a long hit here for the Flames as Sarah Scher collects her third save of the game. Heather Hartman tried to clear it. Kept in bounds there by Barr. Barr trying to tiptoe the sideline. Holmes cuts it out. Plays it forward for Megan Winesett, the freshman, who had a good look at the cage towards the end of the second half, and I guess her stick wasn't at the right angle, as you were explaining to me at halftime, and it just went errant right past the goal. We thought it was one of the best opportunities for the Blue Hens to score. And that ball goes out of play off the Flames. Looked like it might have gone off the foot of Allie Michelson, but the ref didn't see it, and the ball goes back to the Blue Hens, out wide to Holmes, with Ashley Krulak giving chase. Krulak, the sophomore, 10 goals and 3 assists. She is third on the team in points. The top four points getters for the Flames, all underclassmen. Much like the Blue Hens, the top 3 points getters for the Blue Hens are all underclassmen as well. And there's Casey Prettyman, the senior, who's been playing very well offensively for the Hens. Haven't called her name much tonight either. She had 2 goals. She had 2 goals in the CAA tournament, and she's been relatively quiet here today. It really has the entire Blue Hens offense, the Liberty defense, playing extremely well. Hartman is looking to clear it. Gets it up for Papenko. It looks like Hannah Darity on defense. Actually, excuse me, that's number 8, Hannah Jones. Played in the middle. Flames looking to get it out of the circle. They do. And it'll be a call against the Hens. Ball goes back to the Flames.
Delaware has to keep their sticks down, Kyle. A lot of balls, a lot of passes have gone right past their sticks, right under their sticks, right above their sticks. They need to do a better job of keeping their sticks on the ground and getting quality tackles and quality stops.
You mentioned that earlier. Whenever the ball's in the circle, defensemen are taught to really keep your sticks on the ground and not let any of those balls get through. And they need to do a little bit better job of that. And as we mentioned, the Liberty defense doing an extremely nice job of that. Barr coming up there, takes it over the broken line. Janelle Holmes on defense. Barr gets into the circle. We're going to get a shot here from the Flames. Cut out there by Claire O'Malley. Flames still with it. Barr with it now, defending with her body. Shot, and that ball goes high over the cage. Good defense there from the Hens to force Barr to take an awkward shot.
Something I've noticed today, all Barr sisters, Kyle, they're great with the backhand. As we were talking about earlier, field hockey, you can use only one side of the stick, and they've done a great job getting their sticks over to use the reverse side. I'm not sure. I'm not familiar with international field hockey. I'm not sure if that's a trait that's to Ireland. I'm not exactly sure, but all three Barr sisters have done a great job with the reverse side of their stick today.
And the Blue Hens have been right there to, and I'm sure that was in the scouting report that Rolf van der Kerkhoff and his coaching staff have received. Michaela Pastor now with some nice stick work. She's gonna take a shot, goes off the face mask of the goalie, and Jeffress. That was a good look there from Pastor. She was able to get by, good stick work. Had about a 10-yard shot there.
Yeah, we just talked about the reverse side of the stick from the Barr sisters. That was a great backhanded shot there from Pastner on net.
So it might be a European thing. Pastner, a sophomore from Rosenheim, Germany. And that ball goes back to the Flames. So we've seen a relative explosion of offense here so far in the first 9 minutes. Only 5 shots on goal in the first half. We've seen 4 already here in the second half. 3 from Liberty, 1 from the Blue Hens, that lone shot from Patzner we just saw there.
We talked about at halftime those coaching adjustments to be made during halftime. Kyle and I think both coaches have said to their teams, you know, we need to come out hard, you need to leave everything on the field. And when you put shots on net, anything can happen. The ball can take any bounce, anyone's stick can tip it, even a defender can tip it. So I think both coaches have really hammered home that they need to start putting shots on net.
And there's the younger Barr sister, Serena Barr, getting it around Esme Pete. Two talented international freshmen going at it. Jones. Hannah Jones is 5th on the team with points with 21. We mentioned how explosive the Liberty offense is. They have 5 players with over 20 points on the season. That's extremely impressive. And to the credit of the Blue Hens, they have 3. With Casey Prettyman at 19, so almost there. The two very powerful offenses being silenced here by the defenses. Sarah Scher putting together a nice game in her final home game as a Blue Hen.
Hannah Dougherty is checking in for the Flames here, Kyle.
Played into the middle. Well, there's Barr.
A lot of space there for Barr to work with.
Barr's looking to play it forward. It's a one-on-one with Scher. Scher kicks it out nicely. Beautiful job there by the senior, coming out of the her comfort zone there to kick that one away. Michelson, got out there by Barr, taken into the circle, just outside. She's gonna take a shot, goes off the leg of Pete. Pete quickly gets it up to Patzner. Patzner looking to take it over the line, defended by Doolittle. Doolittle did a nice job there to poke that one away. Patzner still fighting for it, has it now, looks to play it up. She's got Megan Winesett. Winesett a little far off the stick of the freshman, cut out there by Jones. Taken away there by Hartman.
Great stick work there by Hartman to bring the ball back close towards her, get a wide open pass up to the midfielders. Now the midfielders up to the forwards and they're moving forward.
And passer, that's pass a little too far for senior Tony Papinko. Papinko getting a lot of playing time here tonight. Rebecca Pepper checks back in for the Hens. Looks like she's taken out Esme Pete. And there's a call against the Blue Hens. Ball will go back to the Flames, and that ball goes out of bounds, so go right back to the Hens.
That was a great step up there by Allie Michelson. She did a good job coming to the ball strong right off of her stick. And that's what the Blue Hen defense needs to keep doing this afternoon, is keep pressing Liberty whenever they have the ball.
That will go off the foot. Number 18, Jordan Richardson. Ball goes back to the Hens. Hartman just looking to clear it. Liberty putting on a lot of pressure here against the Blue Hens, forcing a lot of turnovers in their defensive end. Pepper now. Ball goes off the foot of Rebecca Pepper. Back to the Flames. Quickly, Barr plays it up. Goes off the foot of Michelson. Out wide. The Flames have to bring it back in the middle for their free hit. Serena Barr now. About 5 yards away from the 25. Plays it out wide to her sister Bethany. Playing along the sideline. Good defense there from Claire O'Malley. Ball goes off the Flames.
That was a great job by O'Malley. We were just talking about how the Blue Hen defenders needed to do a better job of keeping their sticks on the ground, keeping them flat. And that's exactly what O'Malley did there. Didn't let Barr get around her with any fancy stick work and was able to clear it out for the Blue Hens.
And Jones played over to Hartman with Richardson on defense. And another turnover forced by this this Flames press. Ball goes back to the Blue Hens. Really trying to clear it now. Hartman, play up to Prettyman. Prettyman tried to get it away. It's cut out by Barr. So I don't know if the Blue Hens forwards need to come down and help out with the clearing, but they cannot seem to get it over their old midfield line.
I think they need to do a little better job, Kyle, of making some more hard cuts, some better cuts. Every time a Blue Hen offensive player gets the ball, they're being swarmed by Liberty. Other Delaware players are sort of just standing around waiting for the pass. They need to cut harder to the ball and create more open lanes, more passing lanes, so the forwards get the ball from the midfielders.
And there's Michelson up to Patzner. Cut out there by Jones. Jones plays it out wide. She's got Pepper and Patzner. Patzner takes it away, taking it back into the middle. Played by Doolittle. Has to play it back to Pepper. And the Blue Hens can finally set up an offense. Played out wide to O'Malley. O'Malley just tries to loft it in. She's got Winesett. Winesett plays in the middle, looking for Patzner, and that ball scoots through everybody. And it goes out wide. Cut out there by Hartman. Hartman taking it into the broken line. Played it into the middle, looking for Winesett, and that ball goes all the way through. And did it touch Flames player Megan Winesett? Thought it did, but it just goes all the way through for a Flames ball as we approach 20 minutes and 30 seconds left to go here in regulation. Still a 0-0 tie here at Rulo Stadium between the 14th-ranked University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens and Liberty Flames. Maddie O'Byrne checks in, some fresh legs. See her hustling over there to get that ball. Heather Hartman now with it, the senior. Played up to Michelson. Excuse me, that's Prettyman. Cut out there by Doolittle, looking for Barr. Winesett now with it. Winesett looking into the middle for O'Byrne. And it seems like the Blue Hens aren't really getting a lot of opportunities off regular set offense. So they're going to try to look for a set play, maybe off a corner, to try to strategically play it into the Flames defender's foot. Seems like that's been their best option so far for tonight's game, this afternoon's game.
All I can say, Kyle, is Liberty has had to watch tons of game film here on the Blue Hens. Every time Delaware has turned forward, looked up for a forward, whether the defense is looking up for a midfielder, there has been at least one, if not two, Flames players right there, right on the ball, pressuring the ball. They put a lot of pressure on the Blue Hens, more pressure than I've seen in the past two games that Delaware's played.
You can only keep these two potent offenses down for so long. Eventually, someone's going to have to break through. And it might be, we were watching the Drexel Northeastern game, on last Friday. It was much like this, maybe not quite at this level, because these two teams obviously both won their conference titles, but it was very back and forth, and we saw kind of a cheapy goal. Like, the defense made a mistake and the ball just kind of bounced into the goal. I don't want that to be the first goal, but it looks like that might be what it is, with both defenses playing so hard. And Pastner takes a spill there, and they win a corner for the Blue Hens, their second of the game.
Seemed like Pastner was tripped up there by a Liberty defender, and that goes in favor of Delaware, and they will get, I'm pretty sure, their second corner opportunity of the game today. Let's see how Delaware will execute this corner opportunity, if they will be able to execute this corner opportunity.
They've had a lot of success with Hartman just stopping it, and then Pete just ripping a shot, but Pete is not in right now. But they have Patzner as well as O'Byrne right behind. Either one could take a shot. Hartman and Winesett, both stoppers. It'll be Patzner. Patzner plays it to Winesett. Winesett with a shot, looking to cross the crease to Prettyman. There's another shot there from O'Malley, and the ball goes out of play off the Blue Hens.
We were talking about Delaware's corner. Casey Prettyman has been completely clutch for Delaware at the right post position. She's done a great job off the top of the circle, going right to the post and tipping the ball in. She had a lot of her goals off that corner this season. And right there you see, I think that was number 19 from Liberty, Natalie Barr, was behind her goalkeeper, stepped up to intercept the pass that was, or the intercept the shot that was going right to the stick of Prettyman, and a great defensive save there by Barr.
And a little collision there between between Pepper and Barr. The ball goes back to the Flames with Jones. Jones plays back to Doolittle. Out wide to Carroll. Cut out there by Pastner. Pastner with some nice stick work. Up the left side. Trying to keep it on her stick. She does. Played up a nice pass to Winesett. Winesett's got O'Byrne in the middle. Looking for a cutout there. A beautiful play by Bethany Barr. Excuse me, that was Serena Barr. And the Blue Hens win another corner.
Barr tried to clear the ball out of the circle there, and a little miscommunication between two Liberty players. Barr lifted the ball into her own player's feet, and that's going to give Delaware another corner opportunity here.
So the Blue Hens threatening here with just under 17 minutes left to go in the second half, trying to break open this game, trying to get on the board. But the Liberty defense, as they've been all game, has really been up to the task. Esme Pete's still not in to take this corner. She's been one of the most dangerous players for the Blue Hens on the corners this year, but Pastner's still in. We'll see if they give her a time and room shot. Hartman to stop. Pastner, she will take a shot. Saved there by Jefferis. Blue Hens still with the ball now. It's O'Byrne. O'Byrne tries to play in the middle. She's got Claire O'Malley. And there's another call against the Flames. It will be another Blue Hens corner, their third in the past 3 minutes and their fourth overall of the game.
I think Delaware's best bet here on this corner is just a hard hit from the top with their post people in the corners ready for a deflection. The Flames defense did a great job all game on the rush that they've had, keeping their sticks on the ground. So I think a hard hit from the top of the circle will be Delaware's best bet for a scoring chance here.
We see their sticks on the ground, and also Jefferis, their keeper, immediately getting to the floor to block any low shot. Here's the stop. Pastner is going to play it out to Sheffers, and another corner. That one goes off the foot of, it looked like, number 15, Aaron Dombach. So the fifth corner for the Blue Hens. And it seems like they haven't really gotten a great look at the cage so far. Their corner execution has been a little sloppy here. But that pass over to Sheffers.
Some strategy, though, too, Kyle. If you're the main hitter off a corner and you see there's nothing there, you're taught to put the ball right into the defense's feet to get another corner right back.
Pass over with a shot. Played in the middle. Oh, and that ball goes just wide. Prettyman was there. It was a deflection off a defenseman's stick. Prettyman had a look at it, but it just goes wide of the cage. So we're now even as shots on goal with six after that barrage of corners there from the Blue Hens.
Hats off to the Flames, excuse me, Kyle, the Flames rushing unit there. When you're rushing back-to-back-to-back-to-back times, you're sprinting as hard as you can out of the cage at the top of the circle, and sometimes your legs get tired, you get out of breath. But Liberty did a great job there pressuring the Delaware corner unit.
And now Esme Pete checks back into the game. Would have liked to see her on one of those corners, but the second leading goal scorer on the team is now back. Prettyman with it now. Prettyman with some nice stick work. Playing to the middle. Oh, she had O'Byrne, but cut out there nicely by Doolittle. Blue Hens still fighting for it. Be a call against the Hens. Carroll plays it up to Barr. That was out wide looking for Jordan Richardson. Playing in the middle. Got Winesett, cleared out by Barr. Back to Michelson. Michelson is trying to shoot it into the circle. Cut out there nicely.
Nicely by Dombach.
As we approach 14 minutes left to go here in the second half, we are still scoreless. Thank you for joining us here on Hens All Access. Alongside Jess Calderon, I'm Kyle Coulter. We've had an exciting game of field hockey going on so far. It's been kind of a chess match. Each team has had their opportunities. Six goals on cage for each team. And Jones taken down there by Pepper, but the call goes against the Flames. Prettyman now with it up to Winesett. Trying to get it over the broken line, but poked away there by Barr. Now the older Barr sister, Natalie. She was looking for Abby Basem. That ball goes out of play. Once again, fans, you can follow the Hens on Twitter at twitter.com/UDBlueHens. Also become a fan on Facebook at facebook.com/BlueHens.
Kyle, the second half, I've seen a big difference with the Delaware defense and the Delaware midfielders. They've done a great job stepping up on Liberty's clear attempts. They've done a great job stepping up to the open passes, stepping off the passes, and that's why Delaware has maintained possession of the ball for most of this second half here.
Passer with some nice stick work gets into the circle. Looking to play it in the middle, and that ball goes out of play. Yeah, it seems the dynamic of this half has switched greatly, where for the first 7 or 8 minutes or so, the Blue Hens couldn't get it past their midline. Now it seems like the Flames can't get it past their midline. So it's been an interesting dynamic change here in the second half. The Blue Hens with four straight corners there couldn't capitalize, but their offense is heating up a little bit here. As we're still temperatures in the 30s here at Rulo Stadium.
I think that's kudos there, Kyle, to Delaware head coach and CAA co-coach of the year, Ralph Von de Kirchhoff. I think he saw some really good.
You all right? It's a little cold in here.
Excuse me, Kyle. I think he did a great job really reading Liberty's game plan in that first half, and he's made the appropriate adjustments here in the second half.
And also credit to Jody Murphy, coach of the Flames, who won the NORPAC Coach of the Year. As Barr gets in the middle, Barr's going to take a shot. Saved there by Cher. Beautiful kick save. Play back in the middle. Blue Hens looking to clear it out, and they get a call against the Flames. So, Barr, we've seen it the whole game, protecting the ball with her body and taking that backhand shot. And that one really tested goalkeeper Sarah Scher, who now has her picked up four saves in this game. And that was a good chance there for the Flames as we approach 11 and a half left to go.
I think the Blue Hens have really realized that all three Barr sisters have really gone to that reverse stick, to that backhanded shot, and then realizing that that has allowed them to defend against that shot better, and that's why I think we haven't seen as much from the Barr sisters so far here in the first couple minutes of the second half.
And the Barr sisters, the only ones to take shots for the Flames so far in tonight's in this afternoon's game. As Ashley Krulak checks back in for the Flames, as well as Sarah Geip, the sophomore from Greencastle, Pennsylvania. Be a long hit for the Blue Hens. Pete plays in the middle. Got wine set. Excuse me, that was Kovaleski. Michelson has it now for the Hens. Playing across field. That ball's a little bit behind Heather Hartman, but Hartman's able to get to it before it goes out of bounds. And there's number 14, Sarah Geip, charging.
It's a good job there by Casey Prettyman-Kyle getting into open space, giving her her right back there a midfielder to get the ball moving forward.
And Coach Van der Kirchhoff wanted the ball to go the Blue Hens' way, but did not get the call. And there's Barr playing up the right side. Janelle Holmes on defense, looking into the middle. Hartman cuts it out. She was looking for the charging Ashley Krulak. But Heather Hartman, the senior, in the right place at the right time, stops that attack for the Flames as we're at 10 minutes left to go here in the second half, still scoreless. Both teams had their opportunities. Defense is playing extremely well. Two of the most explosive offenses in the nation getting silenced here by the opposing defenses. And that ball goes back to the Flames. Barr, put up for Krulak. Trying to get it around Janelle Holmes. That ball goes off the stick of Holmes. It'll be a long hit for the Flames.
The Flames are pressing now really for the first time in the second half, Kyle. Delaware's maintained most possession in the second half, and the Flames are coming right now, coming hard into the circle here.
There's Barr. See if she goes to that backhand. She goes forehand this time. Michelson was there.
And that was a dangerous stick there from Barr. She lifted it a little too high off the ground, and Michelson was right there, right place, run time. It's tough as the defender to get that close to the offensive player because sometimes you'll take a stick off the knee, off a shoulder, even off of your head. But Michelson was lucky there. Didn't have stick hit her in any way, but the ball goes to the possession of the Blue Hens.
And there's a big swing there from Hartman trying to get it forward. Cut out there by the Flames defense. Pete wins that. Actually goes back to the Flames. Looks like they're going to get a substitution now. Looks like it might be Michaela Patzner checking back in. It is Patzner. She will take out Kovaleski. There's Hannah Jones. Played back to Barr. Blue Hens still putting the press on here. Cut out there by Michelson, but they're going to say it went off her body. The ball will go back to the Flames with 8 minutes left to go here in the second half.
This is going to be a crucial 8 minutes here, Kyle. Both teams pressing really hard, getting impatient. Both high-scoring offenses. They're not used to being shut out for this long of the game, so both teams really fighting hard to get that first goal.
The Blue Hens have scored 9 goals over their past 2 games. And the Flames, who have, over the past 12 games, have scored 57 goals compared to only 9 by their opponents. Both teams have none. so far today as Doolittle tries to take it past Prettyman and the two collide. The call will go against the Blue Hens. As the fans getting a little restless here, we hear some thunder coming down. A lot of the Liberty fans trying to make some noise here for their team. Doolittle plays into the middle, and that ball goes wide. She was looking for Krulak. Ball goes back to the Blue Hens. Holmes trying to clear it. And now we see another, as it was early in the second half, where the Blue Hens had trouble getting over their line. It's back to that now as the Flames putting the press on. That ball trying to go through to Patzner. And we get a call there against the Flames. Oh, call there against the Hens. Thought it might have gone off the foot there of Carroll. But the ball goes back to the Flames as Barr has it now. Barr looking up. She was trying to get it to Sloman.
I think the Blue Hens' best bet here to get the ball upfield. Their defense can't be playing with it. They can't be passing it back and forth. They need to hit it as hard as they can, get it over that midfield line, up to their midfielders, up to their forwards, and then attack into the circle.
Serena Barr loses it to Esme Pete. Get a call there against the Flames. Pete still with it now. Pete with it, trying to get into the middle. She's got Winesett. Winesett with her back to the goal. Gonna take a shot. Goes off the hand of Barr. And the Blue Hens have won a corner, so Megan Winesett did a nice job protecting the ball there with her body, turning and firing a shot. Went off the hand or the leg, it looked like a bar. And the Blue Hens get their sixth corner of the game with 6 minutes left to go here. They have Pete, Patzner, Winesett, and Prettyman all in the game right now. They're four leading scorers. So we'll see what kind of play Vanda Kirkhoff calls in from the sidelines as Michelson will be the inserter. Hartman, it looks like, will be the stopper.
Yeah, I'm not sure what Delaware is going to do here in this corner. Everything they've tried today seemed to be just shut down by the Flames.
From the stop. Pastner looking wide for Prettyman. Prettyman's shot! There's a goal! The Blue Hens strike first. They go up 1-0 off the stick of Casey Prettyman. A beautifully designed play. Patzner played it over to Prettyman on the backside, who had a wide open goal and put it in. Beautiful job there from the senior, who has her third goal in three games. Patzner with the assist. That is her ninth of the season. She's now tied with Megan Winesett for the team lead. So the Flames down 1-0 here. Their defense has played stellar all game, but the Blue Hens' sixth corner, it was only a matter of time.
Yeah, we talked about earlier the important parts of the Delaware corner unit, and I brought up Casey Prettyman. That job there on the right post is a crucial position, for any corner unit, and Casey Prettyman just truly excels at it. She does a great job keeping her stick on the ground, great job seeing the ball to her stick, and there's her. That's the second goal I've seen off that design corner play by Prettyman in the past two games.
And Casey Prettyman's 10th goal on the season pulls her to third on the team in goals. She passes Megan Winesett. So the senior, in her last home game, making a big impact. You know, we interviewed her after the CAA championship win where she scored on that play. And she said that they work on that all the time and that she knew she needed to score on it. And it was almost a carbon copy of this goal we just saw here from the senior. And she puts the Blue Hens up 1-0, which could be the deciding goal. Both defenses still playing extremely well. And the Hens really need to buckle down here because we know that the few minutes right after you score a goal is where you're most vulnerable. You tend to get relaxed. But in this NCAA atmosphere, I doubt anyone is relaxed right now.
I love to see a goal any day by Casey Prettyman. She's a local product.
Ball in the middle. And we're going to get a call there against the Flames. Ball goes back to the Blue Hens, you were saying.
Yeah, Casey Prettyman's local product from Newark, St. Mark's High School. Casey Prettyman was actually a freshman at St. Mark's High School when I was a senior. And it's great to see any Spartan alumni excel at the next level.
And she certainly has excelled here. Has had an illustrious career here as a Blue Hen. She is second active career leader in points right now, behind Michaela Patzner.
A fun fact, her sister, Lindsay Prettyman, is actually on the Blue Hen cross country team here at Delaware.
Yes, they are twins here, so both a very athletic Prettyman family. Making an impact here on the trail and the field here in Newark. And the Flames have a break now. There's Barr up the right side with Holmes on defense. Barr with some nice stick work. Has it in the circle. There's a shot. Saved there by Cher. And the ball goes just wide of the net. A beautiful save there by Cher coming out. It was the shot from number 14, Sarah Guype.
That was a great job by Cher. She got on her back, and I think actually that after the ball, she stopped the ball originally. It was trickling past her, and I think she was able to poke it with her stick and get it out of bounds. Great job there by the senior goaltender.
So Sarah Cher, the CAA Tournament Most Valuable Player, showing why she received that honor. She now has 5 saves on the day. Hartman playing it forward. We're going to get a call there against the Hens.
With under 3 minutes here, Kyle, Delaware really needs to get the ball over that midfield line, keep it over the midfield line in their offensive zone, and really waste some time off the clock.
Hartman, Blue Hens trying to clear it, which they've had trouble with doing it all game. Ball's played into the circle. There's a shot! And Barr was not able to get a, that was number 14, Sarah Geip, not able to get a lot on it. Good defense there from Janelle Holmes and Allie Michelson. It's the Blue Hens, crucial clear here. The Flames have forced a lot of turnovers in their own offensive zone tonight.
That was a great scoring chance there by Liberty, but it seemed like Geip got a little bit more of the turf than she did the ball, and sometimes that's tough on such a fast surface. The ball tends to move on you, and that's exactly what happened there to Geip.
And Barr cannot control it. The ball goes out of play. The ball goes back to the Blue Hens with under 2 minutes left to go here. Blue Hens up 1-0 off the stick of Casey Prettyman on the Blue Hens' sixth corner attempt of the game. And they're looking to go out with a bang here at home at Rulo Stadium in their last home game of the season. They're looking to advance to the what would be the second round for them of the NCAA tournament. The winner of this game will take on UNC, the third-ranked team of the nation, down in Chapel Hill this Saturday. The Blue Hens would like to be there. They're 1 minute 15 seconds away. The Flames of Liberty trying to equalize this game. They've had their opportunities so far, but the Blue Hens defense has been up to the task. And it looks like Liberty would like to take a timeout. So we're going to a quick break, but don't go anywhere. We will be right back for the exciting conclusion of this match here on Hens All Access. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Hens All Access's coverage of NCAA Tournament Field Hockey. The University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens are 1:08 away from advancing in this NCAA Tournament. It will be Liberty ball here on the far right side of your screen. It will be right at the 25.
A minute and eight seconds is a lot of time here for this Liberty talented, very talented offensive team. The Blue Hens need to do everything they can right now, Kyle, to maintain possession of this ball, get the ball over the midfield line and out of the Liberty offensive zone.
And despite what you're seeing on your screen, the Blue Hens are up 1-0. Casey Prettyman, the senior, getting that goal a mere few minutes ago off a corner. Perfectly executed corner play. Seconds left now. Ball is lofted into the Blue Hens offside side, and the Flames have pulled their goalie. They now have an extra attacker on the field. So exciting conclusion here. 30 seconds left to go. Flames really pressing now. Barr on the right side. And the ball goes back to the Blue Hens. 20 seconds left. They're just going to look to play it into the corner. 18 seconds left. Jones playing it forward. Krulak's pass a little too far. Able to keep it in bounds. And the ball goes out of bounds. 7 seconds left. And it looks like the Blue Hens will do it. The University of Delaware fighting Blue Hens. They win this game 1-0. As Casey Prettyman, Michaela Pastner, Maddie O'Byrne, and Esme Pete embrace. Their team is running out on the field. Sarah Scher gets a huge hug from everyone on the team, as she should. She played stellar today. And what an exciting game of field hockey, Jess.
What a great game. You know, it's tough to see any team lose a game like this. Both teams left everything that they had on the field today. And you know, Colin, I think if we played maybe 20 more minutes of this game, Liberty may have got another goal, or may have gotten their first goal to tie this game. But that's what happens in sports sometimes, that you just run out of time. And lucky enough for Delaware, the Liberty ran out of time, and Delaware will go on for the 1-0 victory.
And this is the first time in school history that the Blue Hens have notched 17 wins. 17 also special number. The assist coming from number 17, Michaela Pastner. The goal, the lone goal separating these two teams, coming off the stick of Casey Prettyman. Both teams laugh to shake hands, and congratulations to the Liberty Flames. They're only in their third season as a program, and they made it to the NCAA Tournament, and they played extremely well today. The Blue Hens just one goal better in the end, and the Blue Hens will survive and advance to the round of 16, where they will take on UNC down in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, this Saturday at 11:30, and that'll wrap it up here at Rulo Stadium for the Hens. They go 12-1 here at home, so the Blue Hen fans get in a show, and make sure that you follow us on Twitter at twitter.com/UDBlueHens, so you can keep up with that game that will be going on down in Chapel Hill. So the Blue Hens looking to try to be a bracket buster this year, and what an exciting game for all of us here at Hens All Access. Thank you for watching. For all the cameramen, I know it was cold out there, but they did a great job. Producers, directors, everyone. For Jess Calderone, I'm Kyle Coulter. Have a great night, everybody.